Something to think about this time of the year with our late spring weather, which is more winter than spring-like, is water. All those water droplets contain a little bit of dust within them. So each drop is already polluted and tainted. Then you consider what's going on with your al fresco experience if you're actually sitting in the fountain at this time of the year. It's not good. Pollution. All kinds of electrolytes are lost. Some research has to be done. And what research is done at this time of the year? Typically, we're throwing pennies in the fountains. And we need silver dollars.
This world needs
contrary to popular belief, not all water fountains are created equal. And others have varying water flow. Some are very firm, some are very limp. Some even have special attachments to let people fill up water bottles. And they all come in varying heights for varying sizes.
In addition to the various kinds of water fountains, there are also many types of water fountain drinkers.
Big goal for a day.
Water fountains bring people together.
According to our data, approximately 200 randoms pass by the water fountains each passing period at Central Catholic. We decided to interview a few of these randoms and see how they felt about the water.
To get it, and we'll scream at Elliot.
Elliot, get a drink of water.
Elliot, drink the water.
Elliot,
drink the water.
Drink it. God, don't question it. Just do it.
What are you doing? How is the water? How is the water flow? Elliot, stay here. What are you doing? Stay here. How is the water flow?
It's fine.
Would you say it was choppy or was it smooth?
It's pretty smooth, I guess.
Pretty smooth?
Elliot, that's one of the choppy water fountains. Why are you lying to me?
It's so fun.
You think this is a joke? Yeah. You think we're doing this because it's fun? We're doing serious stuff here, Elliot, and you're just screwing around.
I don't know why.
Get the hell out of here. Oh, it's a global studies project. Right. Musa, we've got some questions for you. Come here.
How cold was the water?
It was freezing. You have to take breaks.
Is that cold?
It's cold. What I do is, I drink a little bit, and then I put my tongue up towards the roof of my mouth. I hold it there until it gets warm, and then I go back at it like a soldier.
On the Spanish Room water fountain, how cold would you say the water was?
It wasn't cold, it was like warm. A little bit, yeah.
How was the water flow?
It was decent. Like,
decent?
Let's say the water pressure upstairs is better.
Mm-hmm. It's better, okay. Was it choppy, or was it like silky smooth?
Sort of choppy.
Mm-hmm. Did you like it choppy?
Not like it. No, I don't like it.
Oh, you like it smooth?
Yeah.
Now, if you had to take a guess, what would the pH balance of this water be?
70, maybe?
70.
Oh! We conducted a comprehensive and detailed analysis of the pH balance of each and every water fountain in the school. The conclusions we came to were shocking. All of the water fountains had a pH balance of 7, except for the inside boys' locker room one, which was somewhere between a 3 and a 4.
Like the wild Sahara Desert in Africa, the water fountains can be a dangerous place for the weaker students at Central Catholic.
Baby, just give me a sign.